Amendola Show here in WILK, driven by McCarthy Tire and Automotive Centers, 10:02 in the morning. A lot to talk about as we talk with the Abington Heights boys basketball team live in studio today. And, of course, also going to talk Carbondale area girls basketball. We're going to have the Western Wayne wrestling team in studio with us today. We get ready here to hit it pretty good with my nephew Zachary Mendola in the studio. We get a little background music. Abington Heights basketball team with us, and let's get in with assistant coach Jeff McClain this morning. And Jeff, another pretty good year for you guys, and still growing them big there at Abington Heights. Let's talk about this season. How are things going?
Well, John, we've been very fortunate at Abington over the last 21 years. We've had some very good players. You know, and this group is exceeded expectations. If you look at the team, you know, we have the two seniors coming back, but we also have two sophomores and a junior. So we're relatively a young, very young team. So in the beginning, we had to gel together because a lot of them haven't played together other than the summer leagues and, you know, exhibition and JV. So they've really come together. They play as a team. They're very unselfish. They do a nice job. And it helps when the younger guys are getting beat and we have Seth in the back, you know, to just guard the basket. We struggle sometimes in our man-to-man, and Seth, you know, takes up the slack and helps them out a lot. And they're getting better every day, working hard.
Well, I know we talk about this all the time. It's always great having you and Coach Bianchi up, and we'll talk with Coach Bianchi shortly. But what's it been like being his wingman all these years? And you've been a loyal guy to him.
I played for him back in the 70s, so it's been enjoyable. If it wasn't fun, we wouldn't be doing it. I would have retired long ago, but he makes it fun. He makes it we have a good time together. He's like an older brother. I wouldn't say a father because we're catching up in age together, so I'd say an older brother. And we fight like older brothers. There's sometimes on the bench where we disagree, but he's the boss. He's the head honcho. He's the one that runs the show. I just take his lead and tell the guys what we're going to do.
Well, you guys are doing a heck of a job. Let's welcome in Tommy Rothenberger here on the John Mendola Show, driven by McCarthy Tire and Automotive Centers. And Tommy, let's talk about your role on the team this year.
Thanks for having me on the show. You know, my role is pretty simple. Play good defense, get the guys open, and, you know, I got to knock down my open shots when these guys are struggling, take the pressure off of them.
And it's nice when you have some bigs. Talk about what it's like as the guards looking at these guys saying, okay, let's get the ball into those guys, let them do their thing. If they're off a little bit, we have an opportunity maybe to knock down some shots, or even if they are on, opens up other opportunities.
Yeah, you know, Seth and George are great. They always make sure they're open, easy entry pass to them. And, you know, when teams like to double down on them, so when they double down, they're always great at kicking it out. And just easy from there, we just knock down the open shot.
Tommy, you talk about some of the competition in the league. Always great to play some of those good teams. And there's more than a handful of teams this year that you could go at and say, we're going to get their best.
Oh, you know, the league is very competitive this year. You know, West Scranton, they're always good. And Scranton Prep's exceptional this year. And Valley View's a young team, but they'll be good in the next couple of years. So, league's pretty competitive this year.
Tommy, any other activities for you you're involved with there at Abington Heights?
Oh, yeah, I play football and baseball, too.
And staying busy with three sports. You're obviously a well-rounded young man. Talk about the job you do in the classroom as well.
You know, I'm always a student first, so I try to focus on my grades, and the sports just come after that.
And a senior, so how about those future endeavors? Have you kind of laid out your plan yet?
I'm not sure where I'm going yet, but I'm probably just going to focus on school and college. I just had fun with my three sports in high school.
And how about a major? Just narrow that down yet.
Well, I'm thinking about actuary science or maybe accounting, somewhere along the math field.
Something that sounds pretty smart. So,
yeah.
You keep up the good work, Tommy. Hard.
Thank you.
All right. Coach McClain, Seth Maxwell, let's talk about what he's been doing this year and all the upside that he has for years to come.
You know, a lot of the things that Seth does sometimes doesn't show up on the stat chart. You know, block shots, you know, rebounds. But he alters so many shots in the paint. There are some times where we see opponents driving to the basket and they just stop because they see Seth standing there. You know, he's always helping out. He's always doing what we expect of him to do every night. You know, sometimes it's scoring, sometimes, you know, but he always brings the defensive game every night. And it's a pleasure and a joy, and it really helps all the other kids that are in the game because he's right there and they know that they can press a little bit, and if they get beat, they always have Seth to help out.
Let's welcome in Seth Maxwell here on the John Mandola Show. And Seth, let's talk about the fun you're having with this group this year.
I'm having a lot of fun. Last year, the two freshmen came in, so that now they're starting. I love those guys. I love the seniors. I love Jackson. They're all great. I love playing with them.
And it seems like you grow a little bit more every year. You guys are kind of, you know, 6'10", 6'11". Now you're about 7 feet or so. What's it been like for you to just kind of see that development over the years physically, and then kind of, you know, try to keep your game going and what it's like getting a little closer to the rim?
It's really good on defense. Helps get a lot of blocks. Helps stop defenders or stop offensive players. So I just try to be active on defense, and the height helps a lot.
Let's talk about your guards this year. Tell us about some of the play you're getting out of those guys.
They give me the ball a lot, really well. They can shoot really well. So we all have a threat on the team, so it helps a lot to have them.
And we heard Tommy talk a little bit about the competition for you. Talk about some of that, the guys that you know maybe you play against in the off season that it's fun to play against in this league overall. It's really going to come down to some interesting things over the next few weeks, and of course everybody will go their separate ways for the playoffs.
Yeah, well, it's a lot of fun playing with a lot of the guys that we play in the league. I played with a lot of guys in AAU, a lot of the prep guys, so it's a lot of fun to play against them, but we need to make sure we be intense against them so we get the win.
How about the focus that you've had in the off season, trying to build up a little bit, and things that you try to work on and say, okay, I got to get my left better, I got to be more of a physical presence? What are some of those things?
This year I tried to focus on passing a lot more, because last year I didn't really see the court as well, but this year I tried to see my guys on the court and see everyone at the same time.
And how about the future endeavors for you? You still got some irons in the fire?
I'm thinking probably a prep school so I can get stronger, get more intellectual with basketball, and then see where that takes me.
All right, Seth, well, we appreciate you coming in today.
Thank you.
All right, Abington Heights basketball here on the John Mandola Show, driven by McCarthy Tire and Automotive Centers. And we're going to talk a little bit more. Coach Ken Bianchi in studio. We'll talk with three more players there. For the Comets coming up, the Carbondale Area Girls basketball team in Western Wayne Wrestling. We'll get to those guys coming up here as well. Of course, want to thank our friends at Mendocino's Italian Specialties, located on Sanderson Avenue in Scranton. Of course, you can follow us online during the week, thejohnmandolashow.com, or at Twitter, @JohnMandolaShow. Let's take a timeout. Let's head out now to our local State Farm insurance agent, Frank Sirokatch. Break like a good neighbor. Frank Sirokatch is there. We'll be back here in WILK. Welcome back to the John Mandola Show here on WILK, driven by McCarthy Tire and Automotive Centers. As we continue the conversation with the Abington Heights boys basketball team, a heck of a year. Once again, Coach Kenny Bianchi is doing. Of course, we're going to talk with the Carbondale Area Girls basketball team. They had a big victory the other night against Riverside, and Western Wayne Wrestling also this morning here on the show. And we've had the couple of stories up during the week at John Mandola Show. Again, follow us on Twitter. Well, Coach Bianchi, welcome into the show this morning, and I know we got to talk with Coach McClain earlier. He said some good brotherly battles there on the lunch or on the bench with you guys, and I'm sure you go to lunch sometimes too, but always great to talk basketball with a guy you've been with a long time, and you guys have that special relationship. I know we seem like we talk about it every year, but hey, you got to appreciate and soak all that up as much as you could.
Oh yeah, sure. We get along very well. We don't want to have all yes men on our staff, so we want some disagreement, but once we step on that court, we're all on the same page. And I call us co-coaches. He puts a lot into the program, and we wouldn't be as successful as we are without his contributions.
And we talked a little bit with Tommy and Seth and the job they're doing, and maybe you could kind of give us a little couple sentences about what those guys have done for your program this year.
Well, Tommy and Seth, they're two seniors. Great captain, says for Tommy, he's a leader, and the kids follow him. And Seth really stepped up, especially on the defensive end. Anytime we have a breakdown in our defense, he's just there to protect the basket, and we've been told that by several of our opponents. So it's just been a special year having those two.
And you get a guy like Jackson Danzig, I guess you know what you're getting there with a player like him.
Yeah, Jackson really stepped up this year. What we weren't sure of, when we play an opponent, he usually gets their best offensive player. So he stepped up big time defensively this year, and that really helped us.
And overall, Coach, you talk about the league. Everybody's saying there's great competition this year. We know Valley View's very young, Scranton Prep seems like they keep rising to the occasion and squeaking out a lot of close victories against some good opponents. Scranton's talented. West Scranton will be physical with you every night. That's what everybody wants, though, is that good competition. So when the playoffs come, our District 2 teams are hopefully ready for some of those challenges, because we know it's going to be a challenge stepping outside of District 2.
Yeah, sure. And our league being the way it is prepares us for that. Yeah. Sure, it's nice to win, but you want to have tough games. You don't gain anything by beating teams by a lot of points. It's when it's close games and you lose, then you see how hard you have to work in order to do well in the districts, and it turned out that way this year so far.
All right, well, we'll get back with you and talk to you a little bit about Trey and George coming up, but first let's get to Jackson Danzig. And Jackson, welcome into the show, and let's talk about your role this year on the team.
Thank you for having me. My role in this team is just to come in, keep everyone organized, and just make sure I bring the intensity every single night and keep the energy levels high so everyone stays into the game.
You're a guy who's around a lot of basketball. Of course, it's in the family. So you probably see it a lot. You feel it a lot. And do you kind of get a time or two where it's like, listen, I need a break from basketball overall, or you kind of want to see a little bit more?
I mean, yeah, I'm around basketball a lot with my dad being the head coach over at Scranton University. But during the summer, like the last final part of summer, I'm playing soccer for our school.
Well, that's fun. How about watching your brothers play basketball? What was that like over the years, and to kind of learn a little bit from them?
It's really helped me a lot watching them play for Coach Bianchi and Coach McLean, and then eventually for my dad. I really learned a lot from them. They both really mentored me a lot and really helped me to get to where I am today.
And what could you say is similar about your game with your brothers and maybe a little bit different?
I would say that we all are pretty much pretty decent shooters, and then a little bit different is I'm just a little bit more athletic than both of them.
That's what we like to hear, getting a little better as the years go on. Let's talk what it's like to play with a guy like Seth Maxwell underneath.
It's great playing with Seth, because I know if I ever mess up, he's there behind me to pick up my mistake and then keep the basket secure.
And then how about the challenge to take on the best offensive player on the other team?
I mean, I love it. I love stepping up every day to the occasion, just bring my best foot forward and then keeping them at bay.
And being around these coaches, you said being around your dad, you learn a lot about basketball, but Coach McLean and Coach Bianchi, they have something to offer too. So what do those guys try to teach you day in and day out at practice?
They really helped me a lot. They really taught me to stay focused, keep working hard, and then just never take anything for granted.
All right, well, we wish you well. You still got another year to go, so you'll be thinking about that future for a little bit yet, all right?
Yeah, yes, you. Thank you.
All right, Jackson Danzig here. And again, Dad coaching at the University of Scranton. His brother's playing right now and playing pretty well right now as the U kind of went through a couple of games, tough games there, but I think they'll be back on track here towards the end of the season. Well, Coach Bianchi, we are going to talk about Trey Kohler right now, so tell us about his talents and what he brings to the floor.
Trey's really stepped up big this year. He's probably our quickest player on the floor with the ball. He's a great shooter, good passer, a good team player, and he's had some lapses sometimes on defense, but he's getting much better on that also, and we expect big things from him in the future.
All right, let's welcome in Trey Kohler here on the John Mandola Show, driven by McCarthy Tire and Automotive Centers. And Trey, let's talk about learning from some of these older guys and go through the program there at Abington Heights.
All right, thank you for having me. It's really fun watching Seth play in previous years, and like I picking up defense makes me want to play defense more, and then Jackson's a great scorer, so I just want to like pick up the scoring as well.
And overall, you talk about playing defense at Abington Heights. Let's talk a little bit about what Coach expects of you defensively.
Well, he just makes sure that if I'm guarding a good shooter, to stay up with him and don't give him any space, and then also to help the helper as well, so we don't give up easy baskets.
And as far as what you see on your team out there, what do you think this team has this year that has given you guys such a successful season? Is it, some shooting on the outside, a big presence on the inside? You have a lot of balance?
We have a lot of balance. Like, every one of us can shoot, and everyone is, like, we're all, like, a great family, so we always play with our best abilities.
And other activities for you there at Abington Heights? Any other sports or clubs you're involved with?
No, not really.
All right, so you're a basketball guy.
Yeah.
All right, well, go get him the rest of this year, all right?
Thank you.
All right, Trey Kohler here from the Abington Heights basketball team on the John Mandola Show. And Coach Bianchi, another guy we want to talk about. Let's tell us a little bit about George Tinsley and what he has to offer, another sophomore.
Yeah, George really came on strong this year. He probably is our top scorer, I believe, and rebounder. He gives us everything that he has at all times. He's a pleasure to coach. He's very coachable, and we missed him there for a week with a foot injury. But I also have to mention that Lucas Goodman, who stepped in as his replacement, gave us a double-double in the Honesdale game. So the whole team has been improving as the season went on. But George he'd be sorely missed if we didn't have him in the lineup.
All right, let's welcome in George Tinsley from the Abington Knights Comets basketball team here on the show. And George, let's talk about how you're feeling right now and your season.
I'm feeling pretty great. You know, our team's doing really well. We're just being really aggressive on offense, and the defense always helps with Seth in the paint.
A couple guys 6'5" in this lineup, and of course you're one of them. Let's talk about, you're looking up to a guy like Seth, but overall, talk with the league. When you're playing some of this competition, you guys feel like you're one of the bigger teams, or there's some teams that have matched you height-wise?
We're definitely one of the bigger teams, but there's always another team that has a solid 6'5" around there, lineup. But Seth's definitely the tallest center out there.
And as far as defensively for you guys, let's talk about what you guys try to do. Is a lot of man-to-man? You guys play zone?
It's definitely a lot of man-to-man, just trying to be aggressive and get up in their face, not let them get anything easy.
Take us through a practice with Coach Bianchi, Coach McLean, and correcting mistakes and trying to make sure you guys are going to grow in the course of a practice. Did you say it's an hour and a half really intense, or sometimes those practices get a little longer?
They're a little bit longer than an hour and a half, and they're definitely intense. We run through plays and just make sure we know where we're going at all times. Got to be able to execute.
And then just how about being a part of this program overall and some of the friendships you developed there with the Comets? There's been a pretty darn good tradition over the years at Abington Knights with basketball.
Yeah, I love this school. I love my team, the coaches. Everything's great here.
And, George, any other activities for you you're involved with?
Football.
All right. Well, we wish you well there in your future endeavors, okay?
All right, thank you.
All right, Coach Kenny Bianchi, great to see all the guys today, and, of course, see you and Coach McLean today. And let's talk about the playoffs going forward. I know that's weeks away. You guys will be competing, I believe, in 5A.
Right.
Looking at the standings right now, you guys are at top. Crestwood's on a little bit of a streak right now. And, of course, there's a lot of other teams in that mix, too. But, Mark Atherton's done a nice job with whatever he has every year.
Yes, we're looking forward to the districts. I mean, I don't look ahead at all. Jeff does all that for me. I said we're just going to take a game at a time. With the new rating system and the point system, we don't know where we're going to be. I mean, all we have to do is just keep winning and let the chips fall where they may. And, John, I would like to just say that one thing on behalf of the Abington Heights administration, the coaches, and the players. We'd like to pass on our condolences to Coach Jones from Scranton Prep for the passing of his mother. And they're in our prayers. And, that happening during Coaches for Cancer Week, I just don't think it's a coincidence, and I think it's something that came from above, and they're in our prayers.
All right, well, we thank you for that. Of course, our prayers here at the John Mandola Show as well for the Jones family. And, Coach, we appreciate you guys coming in. Wish you the best the rest of this season. Thank you so much.
Yeah, thank you, John.
All right, Kenny Bianchi, the head coach there at Abington Heights. And, again, Coaches versus Cancer Week this past week. And what a tremendous job District 2 has done. Coach Kettle there at Scranton Prep has really done a tremendous job spearheading that whole event and everybody's involvement with the coaches, the players, the community, and the parents in District 2 has been tremendous. We come back here on the show. We'll continue the conversation. The Carbondale Area Chargerettes will be live in studio. Let's take a break now. Let's head out now to our local State Farm insurance agent, Jen Ricky Loophole. Break like a good neighbor. Jen Ricky Loophole is there. We'll be back here at WILK.